First of all, there's some really exciting new probiotic strains. Probiotics are friendly bacteria. And with each passing year, we're not only discovering these strains, thanks to the Human Microbiome Project, but we're also learning how to grow them. So one of them is called PUF1, P-U-F-1. Now, this was first found in the feces of breast milk-fed infants. Now, it turns out that PUF1 is one of the keys to breast milk supporting health benefits in infants. There have actually been 5 preclinical studies show that the strain may protect against tissue damage in the colon by mitigating pathogen-induced inflammation. Data also shows that PUF1 may regulate immune cells. It's also been shown to stimulate the growth of beneficial gut bacteria. And it also produces large amounts of vitamin B12. Now, there's another really exciting strain that you may have heard about, Akkermansia muciniphila. Now, it's one of the keystone species in our gut and maybe one of the keystone species for good health overall. Now, it was first identified in 2004. Literally, it translates into mucus loving, and it's a species of bacteria that helps maintain our gut lining. Now, Akkermansia fosters the growth of butyrate and other short-chain fatty acid-producing bacteria. And the more, to a point, Akkermansia you have, the more you produce and invite, if you will, the growth of these short-chain fatty acid bacteria. And bonus, the more you produce bacteria that produce GLP-1 agonists. And everybody knows about GLP-1 agonists. Those are the injectable weight loss drugs. And I'll get to that in a minute. So these all work together to improve the gut wall health, mitochondrial health, the immune system's health, and your brain health. Now, Pendulum Life was the first company to offer living Akkermansia in a pill form. I have multiple interviews with them right here on this channel, and please check those out. They're really interesting, and even how the founder, Colleen, decided to investigate this based on the health of one of her daughters is actually very heartwarming. It's a great interview. All right, now let's talk about some of the new postbiotic strains. So tributerin, this is a derivative of butyrate, butyric acid. And I just mentioned butyrate is one of the holy grails of short-chain fatty acids. Now, a study investigated the effect of a 3-week tributarin supplementation on the gut microbiome in 20 healthy adults. 32 participants were given either tributarin or a placebo daily. The results showed that the tributarin increased microbial diversity, that's a good thing, and the abundance of beneficial bacteria producing, spoiler alert, short-chain fatty acids. Participants also exhibited improved gut health markers, including reduced inflammation. Good stuff. Another study investigated the effects of tributarin on gut microbiota and inflammation in antibiotic-treated mice. The study found that just this supplementation alone helped repair intestinal damage by restoring gut microbiome balance and reducing inflammation. Interestingly, the mice treated with tributarin showed improved gut barrier integrity and reduced levels of inflammatory markers. Knowing all this, this is why I put this compound in my best-selling BioComplete 3 formula, and that's one of the reasons that people have experienced such great result with that formula. Urolithin A. Now, Urolithin A is one of the new darlings of postbiotics. Here's the deal. We've all heard that pomegranates and raspberries are really good for you because they have some compounds called agallic acid. And Okay, so far so good. What we didn't know is that only about 17 to 20% of us have a set of bacteria that can take these compounds and turn them into the active compound, which is called urolithin A. Interestingly enough, 50 to 70% of superagers turns out have the set of bacteria that make urolithin A from these compounds. So the point of all that is you could eat all the pomegranates and raspberries that you want, but most of us won't turn it into the compound that we actually need for good health, which is urolithin A. So why do we need it? Well, it turns out that urolithin A is one of the first compounds that has been shown to produce mitophagy, which is basically the recycling of damaged mitochondria, and mitochondrial biogenesis, making new mitochondria. That's a good thing. Number two, studies using urolithin A have shown that it enhances muscle function, muscle strength, and endurance, particularly in older adults and sedentary individuals without a change in an exercise program. It's exercise in a bottle, of all things. Now, cognitive function. Preliminary research has suggested in animal models that urolithin A improves memory and cognitive function. Immune function. Urolithin A appears to enhance immune cell function and actually may help in maintaining immune health in individuals who age. Finally, there's really cool anti-inflammatory effects for overall improved health. Now, there's some animal studies in worms. See the C. elegans model, which I refer to in all my books, as a little worm. Urolithin A supplementation of C. elegans resulted in a 45% increase in lifespan. Now, why is that so important? I mean, so what if a worm lives longer? Interestingly, this animal model has always correlated, the results have always correlated to higher animal models all the way up to rhesus monkeys. In other words, what works in this little worm will almost certainly work in us. Now, in human trials, daily supplementation with urolithin A significantly improved muscle strength and endurance. In fact, one study reported a 10% increase in leg muscle strength after 4 months of supplementation in middle-aged, overweight, and sedentary individuals. Nice stuff. Now, you should really check out my episode with Chris Rinch, the co-founder of Amazentis, which is the company behind MitoPure. The company is called Timeline Nutrition, by the way. Finally, berberine. Now, berberine has gotten a lot of interest as the natural alternative to prescription weight loss drugs like Ozempic, like Wegovy, and like metformin, the diabetes drug. Now, you probably heard that two of the major weight loss companies have decided to market these miracle weight loss prescription drugs as part of their program. Now, I won't go into how these work, but I will provide a warning. So far, it looks from clinical studies that 40%, maybe 50% of the weight loss that individuals experience on these drugs is muscle mass. And the last thing you want to do is lose muscle on a weight loss program, because muscles are what eats the calories you eat. And sadly, placebo-controlled trials show that once you stop this drug, even if you think you're getting the drug, your weight comes back rapidly because your muscle mass is not there to eat it. Now, there is some evidence that berberine can act as a GLP-1 agonist, but it's so much more than that. I'm a huge fan of berberine for many reasons, and it's in actually many of my formulas. It's a polyphenol. It's one of the most potent mitochondrial uncouplers that has ever been discovered. It's also known to activate AMPK. It reduces insulin levels, and it controls blood sugar. It's absolutely amazing. If you want to know more about this, read Gut Check and Unlocking the Keto Code. because it's all in there. More amazing episodes just like this one. Watch now. Unless your doctor tells you otherwise, stop wasting your money on these 7 supplements.